Hey Lakeway friends and family, Pastor Mike here with a little bit of midweek motivation. How is your Easter going? You might be thinking, oh, Easter's still a long way off. But for many people, Easter is well underway. In fact, it began back on February the 17th at the beginning of Lent. Lent is a 40-day period that leads up to Easter, and it is a time of preparation for Easter. A lot of people fast from foods, or they might fast from an activity to prepare them for Easter. And the idea of Lent is it's representative of the 40 days that Jesus spent in the wilderness preparing for his ministry here on earth. You know, Jesus talked a lot about preparation and being prepared. You ever been unprepared? I mean, you know, you sit down for a test, for an exam, you read the first question and you realize right away, I'm not prepared for this. I didn't study enough for this. Or you're making a presentation to your boss or your peers, or your boss and your peers, and someone asks you a question, and you know you should have the answer to that question, but you're not prepared, and you look foolish and you're embarrassed. So let me ask you a question. Are you prepared? Preparation is an interesting word. It has a number of different connotations. In Matthew 22 and Luke 14, Jesus talks about a great banquet that has been prepared. Matthew 22 puts it this way. It says, Jesus spoke to them again in parables, saying, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who prepared a wedding banquet for his son. He sent his servants to those who had been invited to the banquet to tell them to come, but they refused to come. Then he sent some more servants and said, tell those who have been invited that I've prepared my dinner. My oxen and fatted cattle have been butchered. Everything is ready. Come to the wedding banquet. You can kind of hear the plea in his voice. It goes on, it says, but they paid no attention. And they went off, one to his field and another to his business. Luke 14 kind of gets into more detail. It says, but they all alike began to make excuses. The first said, I've just bought a field, and I must go and see it. Please excuse me. Another said, I've just bought 5 yoke of oxen, and I'm on my way to try them out. Please excuse me. And still another said, I just got married, so I can't come. You know, it's somewhat ironic that the Lord has prepared and invited all the guests, everyone, to the great feast, invited all into his kingdom. But some are not prepared to attend. Luke 22, Jesus again talks about preparation. He tells his disciples to go and prepare the Passover meal. And at that Passover, he institutes what many call the Lord's Supper or communion, which we're going to share this coming Sunday. That event is also known as the Last Supper because it's the last Passover that Jesus will eat with his followers before his crucifixion. And while sitting with his disciples, he tells them about all that is about to happen, his betrayal, his arrest, his trial, his execution. He tells them that he's going to leave them, but they're not prepared for such a revelation. And he observes their troubled faces and he tells them of another preparation, and it's found in John 14. He says, do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back to take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I'm going. And Jesus, again, he's teaching about the kingdom of heaven. He says, you can have confidence. If you believe in me, that means to trust in him. He says, I've made preparations for you. I got a place prepared for you. And I'll come and I will take you to be there. It's guaranteed. I love the way it talks about it in Romans 10. It says, and that message is the very message about faith that we preach. If you openly declare that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is by believing with your heart that you are made right with God, and it is by openly declaring your faith that you are saved. As the scripture tells us, anyone who trusts in him will never be disgraced. And what the Bible is saying there is that Jesus has prepared a place for everyone who accepts the invitation. And it says the way into heaven is not by your good works, how good you are, how bad you are, we're all bad. It's about trusting in Jesus Christ that he died for forgiveness of our sin. And that if we confess that with our mouth, we are saved. You know, Easter is good news, but don't make it a weekend event. I want to challenge you to prepare for Easter. Take the journey with Jesus. There are 26 days from today until Easter Sunday. And I'm going to challenge you, read through the gospel accounts of Easter. Matthew starts in verse 26, goes to verse 28, just three chapters. Same from Mark and Luke. All of them are three chapters, Mark 14 to 16, Luke 22 to 24. But my favorite by far is John. 26 days. You know, it begins in John chapter 11 when Jesus heads down to Jerusalem. So chapter 11 and 12 talks about that. And then 13 through 17, I read them all yesterday. Just a wonderful account of the Last Supper. And Jesus talking to his disciples about what's going to happen, about the coming Holy Spirit. And it concludes with a wonderful prayer by Jesus. And then in chapters 18 through 21, we read about Jesus' arrest, his execution, and his resurrection. So it's 11 chapters in all, but you've got 26 days. You get half a chapter a day, and you'd have it covered. For me, I plan to read it through 3, 4, 5 times. I want to challenge you. Prepare for Easter. Get your head around Easter. Read about Easter. Read the Gospels so that on Easter Sunday, on Good Friday, Easter Sunday, Palm Sunday, the week before, you're more than ready for it. It's like, wow, I just read about this. Let the Holy Spirit speak to you. Let the Holy Spirit enrich you this Easter. It's a wonderful thing. It's a core of Christianity. So I challenge you to take the Easter challenge. Read it. Follow Jesus on his journey to the cross. Hey, I look forward to seeing you on Sunday. We're going to look at the 5 habits of healthy people. That's emotional health, spiritual health, and physical health. And I got to tell you right now, I'm feeling a little bit of a hypocrite when I stand up there with my big old pot belly sticking out talking about physical health. But I know it's time for transformation. So join us on Sunday, and we're going to share communion on Sunday. So if you are remote, have some juice, have some bread ready, and we'll share communion at the end of the service. I look forward to seeing you. I love you all. Bye-bye.